Doctor gives you medicine and you think they may be doing you some good. Well, the question is, do they do more harm than good? And could the true secret to healthy living be found through ancient remedies? Well, that's what Suzy Cohen believes. Take a look.
Suzy Cohen is America's most trusted pharmacist. For more than two decades, she's explored the use of vitamins, minerals, and supplements in the treatment of medical ailments. Suzy prefers alternative medicines instead of synthetic drugs to help the body heal naturally without harmful side effects.
Well, Suzy Cohen's with us. She's America's favorite pharmacist, and we welcome her back. Suzy, it's good to see you.
Thank you for being here. Thank you for having me.
What's this new thing? It's like gold, frankincense, and myrrh. It's like you're taking it out of the Bible. Are there remedies in the Bible for it?
Yeah, well, so the three wise men really knew what they were doing.
All right.
So frankincense actually goes by boswellia today, and that's how you'll see it on the back of supplements. And it works a lot like our conventional medicines, things like ibuprofen and Celebrex. It works similar to that. So it's known to help with joint pain and inflammation from head to toe.
Boswellia.
Boswellia or frankincense. Here it is. I have a picture of it. Actually, here's the powder. It's ground up. I put it in my joint script. And here it is. We have gold, frankincense, and myrrh right there. Not gold, it's chocolate, but
good
as gold.
Well, okay, what about the myrrh? That was embalming fluid.
Yes, it used to be embalming fluid and also used in incense. Do you want to smell it?
Okay.
This is an essential oil, and this is actually a gum resin.
Well, all right, when they were bringing gold, frankincense, and myrrh, what were they doing? What was the significance of it?
So they were gifting the baby Jesus, and these were used in ancient times to help control different things. They were using it for various different ailments. So the myrrh is actually very famous. It was used in ancient times, in biblical times, with warriors who were sent into war who might have developed gangrene, for example, because myrrh is actually very helpful for skin wounds. In fact, I put it on my skin. Yesterday, I cut my hand while I was signing a book, and I was autographing a book in the plane for somebody, and
completely healed.
Almost, yeah. Somebody got a bloody book, though.
All right, so you get myrrh, all right, and then you got... So they didn't actually ingest gold, did they, or did they?
No, but today there's an injectable drug called Redora, and that goes by other brand names, that's used for arthritis. So this tells you just how potent some of these compounds are. In ancient times, we didn't know it back then, because we've studied it today, but they had anti-cancer benefits as well. So we're starting from this side.
All right, well, go over there and tell us. You're making these compounds and selling them, or is somebody's?
Yes, these are all three custom designed patented formulas of mine.
Okay.
I was trying to fill a gap. You see, I'll just put it out there. Big Pharma is now involved in making supplements. Some of the most popular dietary supplements in health food stores and in pharmacies are made by pharmaceutical companies. So they've kind of gotten in on the action on that side of the counter. And not everything you buy is high quality. They're loaded with fillers and high fructose corn syrup and unnecessary excipients and additives and artificial everything. And I wanted to stop that. Okay. I wanted to change that. I mean, simple things. Like, I told my mom, go get vitamin C. And when I went to visit her, I saw what she was taking. I was like, this is a real head scratcher.
Why are you taking
this junk? So I decided to make clean.
Is this ascorbic acid? What was she taking?
I don't want to name the brand, but she was just taking something that had like seven ingredients. It should have just been pure vitamin C and bioflavonoids, but it wasn't. Something so simple as vitamin C or vitamin D, people will go and buy and they're wasting their money. This is a $21 billion industry for natural supplements. And it's big business, and it's big business for Big Pharma now.
All right, well, let's talk about these. Now, this is your brand, or whose brand is it?
This is my brand.
All right, well, let's talk about it. What's that first one there?
Okay, this is called Glucoscript, and it contains various different herbal ingredients. Here's bilberry. They're kind of like dried up blueberries. You want to feel them?
All right.
It's called bilberry, which is well known in the literature to support vision.
Do you eat these things or swallow them? What do you
do? No, I wouldn't eat them. You could. Yeah. It's not going to taste good. It's going to be a little sour.
All right.
So you can make a tea out of it.
Okay.
What you would do is steep the bilberry. What I have shown here is bilberry and holy basil.
All right.
And these are known to help with blood sugar support. And when you can get the blood sugar, get the sugar out of the blood and into the cell,
yeah,
it balances your blood sugar, and this reduces cravings. So we're coming into Thanksgiving.
So this is diet stuff.
Yeah, this one right here could help with blood sugar support and craving control.
All right.
And I mean, I'm still going to circle the buffet like a shark, but still.
What do you call that thing? Well, let me see it. I'm talking about your label. What do you have?
Oh, this is Glucoscript. Well, it also has resveratrol, which people are drinking red wine.
Yeah.
By the gallon. Okay, so here's the big secret. Red wine doesn't have a whole lot of resveratrol.
Yeah.
It's touted that way, but you'd have to honestly drink like 10 bottles to get a therapeutic dose. So I put a therapeutic dose in here.
Oh, there's a little bit of resveratrol. It's called Glucoscript.
Glucoscript.
All right, now what's the next one you've got?
For glucose control. Okay, so the next one is Joint Scripts.
All right.
It has all kinds of things in it. It has ginger right here.
All right.
Which you are used to if you eat sushi, or people know it for its anti-nausea effect.
Mm-hmm.
And pregnant ladies use ginger for nausea.
Right.
And then it also has frankincense, which was listed back in Genesis and all through the Bible. I'm sorry, in Song of Solomon and other excerpts of the Bible.
Right.
So it's throughout the Bible. And then here we have the gold, chocolate gold, frankincense and myrrh.
Right.
And then in Thyroscript, that's the last one. That could help support a healthy mood
energy. This one is called Thyro, and this is for the thyroid.
Yes.
All right, well, what do you do?
So the thyroid gland is a butterfly-shaped gland,
yeah,
the base of your neck, and it's in charge of how warm or how cold you feel.
Mm-hmm.
And it also helps control mood. So if you feel tired and you can't cope, thyroid support may be in order. And what I have shown here is mullein leaf. You can feel it. They're soft and fuzzy. It's kind of like a weed, but it has strong antibacterial elements to it.
Mullein.
It's actually used for tuberculosis and leprosy.
Where do you get it?
Well, it grows on the side of the road.
Really?
I have it sourced from a purified, you know, dealer.
Yeah.
All of my supplements are made in the lab.
You're not out there on the road picking these things, huh?
No.
Okay.
No, everything is sourced. All of my supplements are created in FDA-approved labs, and everything here is clean. And ashwagandha is that last herb in Thyroscript, which supports the adrenal glands. So it's kind of like a wet blanket for people who are stressed out. And then I brought this.
Well, that's the Rubik's Cube. You don't need to take that, do you?
No. Go Broncos, right?
Yeah, okay.
Actually, this was brought to show you that if you can distract yourself a little bit and put something in your hand, then you're less likely to put your hand in the cookie jar.
So
you could play with that, take a Glucoscript.
This is not just for frustration, this is for diet. This will ease
right,
you.
Right.
Okay.
And then I brought the almonds to show people that if you eat 10 to 15 of these a day, it could act like aspirin in the body.
Almonds?
Yes, they contain
almonds.
Salicin.
Yeah. But that kills pain or?
Yeah, if you
pain.
Eat 10 to 15 per day, preferably organic, then that acts like aspirin. So taken together, what we have are herbs from the Bible, not all of them, but many are herbs from the Bible, and they work towards healing the body. And I guess the biggest message for me, for people listening today, is that if you're coming into the holidays and you're worried about stress and mood and appetite and pain and all these things, put less power in the prescription pad and think about God's plants. After all, that's all we had before some great businessman decided to pluck them from the earth, take them to a lab and morph them.
Well, this is bilberry, holy basil, ginger, almonds, frankincense, and myrrh. And
mullein.
I've never heard of mullein before. That's something new for me.
Yeah, it feels like felt.
And ashwagandha.
It's so strong. It has antibacterial activity against MRSA, leprosy, and tuberculosis. It's also a powerful anti-inflammatory.
That's unbelievable. This one little leaf.
Yeah.
God put some amazing pharmacopoeia, didn't he? I mean, it's really amazing.
God is very smart.
Well, what are the big companies doing, Suzy, that takes this away from God's plan? What are they doing with it?
They pluck these plants from the earth, and they're pretty crafty about it. I mean, you can't blame them in a way. They've got a business to run, right,
sure,
at our expense. we're the cash cows for the business. And they pluck the plants from the earth, they take them to a lab, they attach a chemical by force to it so that they can apply for a patent. And then they test it on a number of people. It goes through a series of testing, not as many as you would think.
Yeah.
Phase four studies are often on the population.
Mm-hmm.
And then they market it very nicely on commercials, on TV, and through, you know, marketing efforts with the physicians. Now, I don't want people to think I'm anti-drug, because I wear my white coat with pride.
Mm-hmm.
And as you know, my husband has been ill for many years. And if we didn't have certain antibiotics and medications,
yeah,
he would have passed away. So I'm very grateful he's doing well, and he, it's thanks to medicine. Well, and many people, many viewers are watching.
That you hit so hard was the most popular drug that they've got out there is called Lipitor, and those other statin drugs. And you talk about vitamin muggers. That was so appealing. Tell us about that still.
So since our last show where we talked about how statins reduce levels of CoQ10, more research has shown that it also reduces selenium in the body. Selenium is needed to protect your prostate. It's also needed to run a metabolic pathway in the body and an enzyme called glutathione peroxidase, which is basically a big word for an enzyme that does good housekeeping on your cells and cleans it up and sweeps your cells out. So these statins mug CoQ10, which causes muscle cramps and memory loss, and the depletion reduces levels all over the body and affects our thinking and our mood. But it also, now we've seen that it reduces selenium, which can affect our prostate and affect our ability to clean up solids.
Why don't they pull this off the market?
Well, I think that there's some anti-inflammatory effects that they use with these for these drugs, and you know, there is some warnings on them. There's warnings on those acid blockers now. Those acid blockers can cause such a severe depletion of magnesium in the body that there's a warning on there that it could be fatal. And yet people take these acid blockers, certain ones, not all, every day with their food in order to eat. I would just skip the chili bean burrito, personally. No, I'm kidding.
You're talking about which ones specifically?
The proton pump inhibitors, like omeprazole, for example. It's sold over the counter without a prescription in the United States. And it can cause such a severe depletion of magnesium in the body that it can affect the heart. Low magnesium can stop the heart. In fact, when you go to the ER with a heart attack, one of the first things they give you is magnesium by IV. So it's so severe, the depletion.
More people are dying from prescription medicine than they are probably from a lot of other causes, aren't they? I mean, you know what the statistics are?
Over 100,000 people will die at their own error, just taking medicines wrong or miscombining them or combining something incorrectly. Over 100,000. It's untold how many people will pass just due to incorrect combinations in the hospital, which just go down on the chart as, you know, sudden death or cardiac arrhythmias.
Well, those statins are just deadly, and I'm with you on that. And people don't realize that what they do to you, they give muscle aches and they give weakness.
And the diabetes medication, that was one of the reasons I created Glucoscript, was my mom had diabetes at one point. She no longer does.
Okay.
A lot of people do not after they read my book diabetes. And so I created this formula because metformin, the most popular diabetic medication, can deplete CoQ10 just like the statins, exactly like
metformin
the statins.
Metformin does that.
Yes. It can deplete CoQ10 and B12. And that affects your nerves. So then here you have a diabetic taking a drug, which don't stop taking your drug. Because just supplement with what the drug is stealing, which I would say CoQ10 and B12. And the reason is because when you run out of B12, you get pins and needles on your hands and feet, right? Peripheral neuropathy. It's very common with diabetes.
Well, that's what they advertise.
But the drug can cause it. Because through the depletion of methylcobalamin, or B12, well, the methyl part of methylcobalamin, B12, wraps your nerve fiber. It's like the coat, it's like the copper coating on a wire. So when that unravels, you feel the pins and needle and the pain. And then you can't play with your Rubik's Cube.
Oh, Suzy, this is... Well, anyhow, one last book you've got is called Thyroid Healthy, and the thyroid is so important. for, well, it's a whole lot of things. It's growth and weight gain and loss, it's a complete book. Suzy's books are fabulous, but...
That has secrets in it that no one else will tell you.
Okay.
The right labs to take, not only the right labs, but the right ranges of labs, because the normal values that the physician tells you is, in my opinion and many experts, it's wrong. So they dismiss you and say you're going to be fine, your levels are normal.
Does the medical establishment send some little man out in the dark of night to take you out, or do they leave you alone?
They leave me alone. I'm not doing anything bad. I'm just shining a light on people who are frustrated and scared and afraid of, you know, how they're going to face tomorrow. There's people right now that are struggling, trying to figure out, should I keep going? I hurt so bad, I can't get out. I'm scheduled for an amputation.
This is horrible.
I can't do anything because my range of motion is bad. And these simple herbs that have been around since biblical times can help people.
If somebody's watching this show and they want to get this stuff, how do they go for it?
My website has all the information. It's SuzyCohen.com. And for all of our viewers, I'm giving away a gift called Medicinal Herbs from the Bible. It's my newest ebook, and I've dedicated it to you and Dee Dee.
Well, how sweet. Medicinal Herbs of the Bible. I'm a great believer
in
that.
It's free to everyone.
I'm a great fan of nuts. I'm a great fan of berries. And there's so much natural goodness in these things, and I'm not a fan of all the sugar that's out there and the salt. So, I mean, I'm going on and on and on.
No, and I agree. And that's the gap that I'm aiming to fill, because people think that the natural supplements are going to help them. And many supplements out there are laden with high fructose corn syrup, artificial colors and fillers. Mm-hmm. So it's not even anymore about, I'm going to get off this medicine and try this natural supplement. Now you've got to think one step ahead. Keep your head on swivel, right? You got to keep thinking. What's in my supplement? Will it cause more harm than good? Because sometimes you're better off not taking a supplement if it's laden with things that are going to clog up your kidney and tax your liver and use up your precious antioxidants.
Ladies and gentlemen, they're out to get you. Suzy Cohen, tremendous, brilliant young lady, and I appreciate her being here again. And you want to look up SuzyCohen.com? That's it, SuzyCohen.com. God bless you. Thank you.
God bless you, too.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for the opportunity.